fifth graders, I'm Trent. In the fifth grade, you need to learn math concepts for many reasons. Concepts are big ideas. Understanding the big ideas will help you do well on the AIMS test, get better grades in math, and prepare you for math classes in the future.
Plus, it is fun to solve problems and use parts of your brain you have never used before. When I solve a challenging math problem, it makes me feel great. I know the more I learn now, the brighter my future is. My name is Alexis. Let's get on with the show. We hope you enjoy
What's the Big Idea?
The big idea of this video is systematic listing and counting. Fifth grade students can solve problems by developing and using listing and counting skills.
Charts, lists, and tree diagrams can help students understand the multiplication principle of counting. Systematic listing and counting is a great way to analyze and solve some math problems.
Let's check in with our math vocabulary person, the MVP of What's the Big Idea, Jonah.
Thank you, Trent. Let's look at two math phrases used in this math lesson, systematic listing and tree diagram. Systematic comes from the root word system. It means to do something in a logical and organized way. Fifth grade students can solve some problems by making a systematic list. A tree diagram shows all possible outcomes of an event with branches or line segments connecting items or choices. It looks like this. Let's say students have a choice of three sandwiches and three drinks in the cafeteria. Each student can have only one sandwich and one drink. The sandwich choices are ham, turkey, or pastrami. The drink choices are water, milk, or juice. A systematic list would be HW, HM, HJ, TW, TM, TJ, PH, PM, or PJ. You can see there are 9 combination of lunches in the cafeteria.
You can show the same outcomes with a different kind of systematic list, a tree diagram. Write down ham, turkey, and pastrami. Then show 3 branches from each sandwich to water, milk, and juice. There are 9 branches on the tree diagram.
I see the same 9 outcomes in your diagram that Jonah had on his list. So there is more than one way to solve a problem. Let's look at this problem. Will you read it, Alexis?
I'd love to. For school, Sam has 2 pairs of tennis shoes, white and orange. He has 2 pants, blue and tan. He has 3 shirts, red, green, and purple. How many outfits can he wear with the clothes listed? He must wear 1 matching pair of shoes, 1 pair of pants, and 1 shirt.
How would you solve this problem? Tell your classmate in a quiet voice how you would solve this problem.
Now, with a classmate and some scratch paper, make a list with letters or use a tree diagram and show how many outfits Sam can wear to school.
Did you show 12 different outcomes? Did you use letters and make a systematic list? Or did you make a tree diagram? Either way, you should get 12 outcomes.
It's fun to use different strategies to solve word problems. This has been my favorite show so far. I'm going to go home and make tree diagrams all afternoon.
Thank you for watching this video. What's the big idea? Systematic listing and counting. Learning fifth grade math, big ideas, is awesome. We appreciate your attention and hope you like this video.
Math rocks. For Trent and MVP Jonah, I'm Alexis. See you next time on
What's the Big Idea?